My name is Nitesh Narasheth. I am from Annavara. So last class we are discussing about a topic from 8th standard, that is exponents and powers. So in exponents and powers we already discussed about what is meant by exponent, how we are taking the negative exponent, what happens when we take the multiplicative inverse of negative exponents, and the expanded form of this numbers when we have a decimal places. So those parts we discussed in the last classes. So let us move on to the next part, that is laws of exponents. Already you know that we have a standard identities. So when we have algebraic equation, algebraic expressions, so then we can easily use the standard identities. But when we have exponents, so minus 2 we have, negative exponents we have, positive exponents we have. So in that case we are continuously taking the reciprocals and we are continuously taking the inverses, means it is very long time, it needs a long time. So for that one, so we have some of laws of exponents, so we can use in some of the problems to get the solution. So let us look at the some of the laws of exponents. Laws of exponents. Yes, so there are some of the laws are there in the exponents, so we have to use in this chapter. So let us take the first one. So here firstly I will take any number, the base. So any exponents we have the two terminology, that is one is the base, another one is the exponents. So here I will take the base as a, b, c, d, like that, and exponent as m and n. So when we need different exponents means we have to use m and n, and when we have a different base means, so we have to use a and b. So you can use x or y, x and y, p, exponents as a p and q, whatever it may be. But here I am using a, b as a base, and m and n are exponents. So let us take that one. So firstly I will take a raised to m divided by a raised to n. Yes, here just observe, there are two exponents here. Here base is same, but exponents is different. Those are in the denominator, that means it's a numerator and denominator, it's in the form of division. What happens after we taking that one? So here we have to express this equation, so or this division, in the form of single base. So we have to consider single base. Base is common here, that is we have to use a only. And what happens? What happened to the exponents? Here already we know that one. That is when we have. So here m is there, here n is there, means when we multiply above here, so then we have minus n, a raised to minus n. That means here it is not only the n. When we take into the numerator part, it comes as a minus n. Yes? So here, let us take one look at. So here we know that 2 into 2. That means here 2 raised to 1 is there and 2 raised to 1 is there. Here 2 raised to 1 and 2 raised to 1. So already we know that it is 4. 2 into 2, we have a 4. But 4 can be expressed as a 2 square. Here just observe, the only the exponent part added here. The exponent part is added here. So that means another thing, let us take another example. Here I will take 3 square into 3. Let's take that one. Here 9 into 3. 9 into 3 here. 9 into 3 is equal to 27. 27 is known as the 3 cube. Yes, is equal to 3 cube. Here just observe, here 2 is there, here 1 is there. Just that means when we take the two exponents and two raised powers, that means raised terms here, the exponents will be added. The exponents will be added at the result. So that means here also we have to take the same thing. So here just observe, here a raised to m is there and here divided by a raised to n is there means here a raised to m. So when we take into the numerator part, it comes as a minus n. That is a raised to minus n is equal to. So already we observed that when we have two exponents multiplied together, then we can take the addition of this exponents having a same base. That is a raised to m minus n. So that is m plus of minus n. We get m minus n here. Yes, m minus n. Yes. Also look at this one. Here multiplication is there. Here it is a raised to m and a raised to n. Just let us observe that one. Here it is the positive exponents only. Here I am just taking the positive exponents only. So that means here we can take the next exponents also. The next law of exponent, that is a raised to m into a raised to n is equal to. So here it's in the division form. So we can convert it in the multiplication form, taking the multiplicative inverse of the second term. Already we know that. Yes. So here we have the this thing. And the same thing we have here. So a raised to m into a raised to n is equal to a raised to m plus n. So whatever the thing we have, whatever the two exponents and powers we have, so those can be, in those the base is same, the exponent is different means. So having the same base, with the same base we can add only the exponents. It is possible. Yes. So this is the second law of exponents. Yes. So let us take the third one, this. Yes. So here the third one. Here let us take same base, same exponents with the different bases. So let us take that one. That is, firstly I will take a raised to m into b raised to m. A raised to m into b raised to m. So let us take that one. So 3 into 2. Yes. Here 3 raised to 1 and 2 raised to 1. Here only 3 raised to 1 and 2 raised to 1. It is equal to 5 raised to 1 now. 5 raised to 1 only. So that means here just observe, here we have different bases having the same exponents. Here we get the same number. So when we multiply, yes. So let's take the another one. 2 square into 3. Sorry, here 3 square. Let us take, here exponents is same and the base is different. Yes, 2 square into 3 square. Here 4 and here 9. So is equal to 36. Yes. So let us take 2 into 3. Yes. 2 into 3 whole square. So here from this I just taken that one. 2 into 3 raised to square. That means 6 square. Whether 6 square is equal to 36? Yes. So whatever the example you can take, this will be right. So therefore we can take is equal to a into b whole raised to A into B whole raised to M here. So this one is the third law of exponents. So let's take the fourth one. Here we have the division. So let's take the, here we have the multiplication. Let's take the division here. Yes. So A raised to M divided by B raised to M is equal to A raised to M divided by B raised to M. So what happens here? So here likewise. That means, so here a into b is in the bracket, likewise we have a by b is in the bracket. Whatever the example you can take, that will be correct only. That is a by b whole raised to m. So firstly we have to divide a and b and then we have to take the exponent of that one. So the answer will be the same. Okay. Yes. So this is the fourth law of exponents. Yes. Let us move on to the fifth law. Fifth law is nothing but it's having the same base and having a two different exponents. On the same base we have a two different exponents. That is only one base we have. So here we have a exponent n. On that we have another exponent. On that we have a another exponent. So let's take that one. So 2 raised to 2 whole raised to 1. So it is equal to 4 only. Yes. So here we can take 2 raised to 2 into 1. Exactly. Then, so let us take the another example. 3 square whole square. Yes, so let us take that one. 3 square means 9. 9 square is equal to 81. Yes, so let us take 3 raised to 2 into 2. 3 raised to 2 into 2. 3 raised to 4. 3 raised to 4 means it's also 81. When you take the multiplication of this 3 raised to 4, you get 81 only. So that means, so here we have two different exponents or two same exponents, whatever it may be. Here m and n are same and m and n are different. The answer will be the same, that is a raised to m into n. Whatever the raised to 4 we have, so we have to multiply all and take that one as a single exponent for this single base. Yes, I hope you understood that one. So the finally the another exponent, we already learnt that one in the expanded form also. When we explain about the negative exponent, I just informed those things. So the last exponent is when a base having an exponent 0. So what happens there? A raised to 0 is equal to 1. A raised to 0 is equal to 1. So these are the 6 laws of exponent. Using 6 laws of exponent, there are many many examples are there. So you have to use that time. So let us take some of the examples of exponents and powers, and using laws of exponents we have to solve those problems. Let us take one by one. Yes, so let us take some of the problems are based on laws of exponents, that questions or that problems we have to solve using the suitable laws of exponents. So let us take the two problems here just observe in those two cases. So here we have the bases. Here it is minus 2. Base is only minus 2. Here base is only 3. That means here the base is different, but the exponent base is same. Here the exponent is different. Here exponent is different. The base is same. So that means we have to use the first two formulas. That is a raised to m into a raised to n is equal to a raised to m plus n, and a raised to m divided by a raised to m is equal to a raised to m minus n. So that those two exponents we have to use here. Yes, so let us take those laws of exponents to solve these two problems. Yes, so let us take the first problem. Here minus 2 raised to minus 3 into minus 2 raised to minus 4. That means here the base is same, exponent is different, and followed with the multiplication sign. So that's why we can use a raised to m into a raised to n is equal to a raised to m plus n. Before that, better to write we know that. It is we know that. Because here we know that one, that is a raised to m into a raised to n is equal to a raised to m plus n. So that one we have to write. We know that a raised to m into a raised to n is equal to a raised to m plus n here. Yes. So after that we have to write what's the value of a, what's the value of m, and what's the value of n. Then we have to substitute the same in the equation. Let's take that one. A is equal to minus 2, and what's the value of m is equal to minus 3, and n is equal to minus 4. So we have these values. So we have to substitute these values in this law of exponent. That is minus 2 raised to minus 3 into minus 2 raised to minus 4 is equal to. So here we have the thing, the original problem. So we substituted in this LHS side, and along with that one we have to insert in the RHS. So what's the value of A? Minus 2, and we have to the bracket here. Yes. So then my m plus n, that means what's the value of m? Minus 3. This is the first term, no need of taking the bracket, and for second term we have to insert the bracket. Yes. Plus minus 4 is equal to minus 2 raised to minus 3 plus minus 4. Here what happens? Here minus 2 raised to minus 3 plus into minus 2. is equal to minus 3 minus 4 is equal to minus 7. That is minus 2 raised to minus 7 is the answer. And what's the answer for this one? So what's the answer? What is the question for this answer? Here minus 2 raised to minus 3 into minus 2 raised to minus 4. So this is the answer. So only it is enough. It is the solution of this problem. So here we use only one exponent here. So and if you want to use the further exponents, you can use if it is possible. Yes. So let us move on to the next problem. Here just observe here the first is the division form is there, here it is a multiplication. So that means we already learned about what was you. That means firstly we have to open the bracket. Okay, firstly we have to open the bracket, after that we have to do other operations. Okay, so here just observe it's a division form. So let us write in the division form. 3 raised to minus 7 divided by 3 raised to minus 10 into 3 raised to minus 5. Firstly we have to solve this. So here just observe the base is same, exponent is different and it's in the division form. So let's take the division form of the exponent, loss of exponent, which one is that? A raised to m divided by a raised to n is equal to a raised to m minus n. So here a is equal to 3 and m is equal to minus 7, n is equal to minus 10. So let us directly we can take that one, no problem. Here 3 raised to minus 7 divided by 3 raised to minus 10 into 3 raised to minus 5 is equal to here 3 raised to minus 7 minus of here m is value of m is minus 7 and value of n is minus 10, value of a is 3. So here we have to substitute all the things. Here minus 10 is there, so that's why we have to insert the bracket into 3 raised to minus 5 remains as it is and is equal to 3 raised to minus 7 minus 1, 3 raised to minus 7 minus of minus plus 10 into 3 raised to minus 5 is equal to 10 minus 7 3, 3 raised to 3 into 3 raised to minus 5. So it's in the form of a raised to m into a raised to n, that is base is same, exponent is different, followed with the multiplication sign. So that's why we can use a raised to m into a raised to n is equal to a raised to m plus n. That is 3 raised to 3 plus of minus 5, because here we have to write the reason. That is a raised to m into a raised to n is equal to a raised to m plus n. So is equal to 3 raised to 3 minus 5 plus into minus minus is equal to 3 raised to minus 2 is the answer. 3 raised to minus 2 is the answer. So that one we can write it as 1 by 3 square is equal to 1 by 9. 1 by 3 square is equal to 1 by 9. We can write this is the answer of 3 raised to minus 7 divided by 3 raised to minus 10 into 3 raised to minus 5. So finally the way we get the answer is 1 by 9. So there are many problems are there. So we have to use the laws of exponents here. So let us move on to the next set of problems. Yes, so let us take the second set of problems. Here just observe there are two problems are there. And when you look at the problems, here just observe there is no any same basis. Different basis we have. And also along with that one we have a different base, different exponents, sometimes same exponents also we have. So we have this like problems. Yes, so here also we have to use laws of exponents, but here it is in not in the form of single law of exponent. Here we have to take that law of exponent which is suitable for this step. So that's why we have to use the multiple law of exponents in the same problems. So let us take those problems here. So firstly I will take this problem here, just observe 1 by 2 raised to 3 whole square. That means here we know that here 2 raised to 3 is there and here square is there. We can't take directly. we can't take directly because it's in the form of different law of exponent. So that's why we have to use first that exponents and then you have to insert that other law of exponents in that situation. So let's take that one. Yes. So here this is the form of a by b whole raised to m. Actually, this is in the RHS side of one of the laws of exponent. But here it is in the form of that form. So that's why we have to convert it in the form of LHS side of this. So let's take that one. That is a by b whole raised to m is equal to a raised to m divided by b raised to m. So in that form we have to convert. So let's take that one. Here 1 by 2 raised to 3 whole raised to 2 is equal to 1 square a raised to m divided by b raised to m, that is 2 raised to 3 whole square. Likewise we have to take. And then, so here 1 is only as it is, here 1 square means 1 only, and here this of the 2 raised to 3 whole square, it is in the form of a raised to m whole raised to m. That form we have, so that's why we have to take 2 raised to 3 whole raised to 2 means here a raised to m into whole raised to n is equal to 2 raised to 3 into 2 a raised to m into n. 3 into 2. So that one step you have to write must and should, because here you have to write the valid reason. A raised to m whole raised to n is equal to a raised to m into n. That one step you have to write. These two are in the form of same. Yes. So let's take the next. Here 2 raised to 3 into 2, that means 2 raised to 6 is equal to 1 by 2 raised to 6 means 64. Yes, that is 1 by 2 raised to 3 whole square is equal to 1 by 64. How we get 64 here? Multiply 2 6 times. So then we get the 64. This is the answer for this question. Yes, so let us move on to the fourth problem here. So here just observe, here 3 is there, here 10 is there, 25 is there, 5 is there, 6 is there. So just observe that. So here 3, 5 and some of them are prime numbers. Here some of the composite numbers are there, 10 and 6. So we can change that composite number in the form of product of prime factors. Yes. So that one must we have to write, because so when we have this thing, so we can easily solve out this problem with the help of laws of exponents. So firstly we have to take those things, that is 3 raised to minus 5 into here. 10 can be write it as 2 into 5. Yes, 2 into 5 whole raised to minus 5. And 125, how can we write that one? So here not only look at the composite number, also we have to look at whether it is perfect cube or perfect square. That one we have to observe. So whether it is perfect square, no. Whether it is perfect cube, yes, it's 5 cube. So then we have to write 5 cube. So that's why it is very easy. Then this means as it is 5 raised to minus 7, 5 we can split, and 6 we can split as a 2 into 3. That is 2 into 3 whole raised to, because here 125 is equal to 5 cube. We know that one. Yes. So then, so let us take the next step. Yes, here we have a into b whole raised to m. Here also a into b whole raised to m. So let us take that one. 3 raised to minus 5 into 2 a into b whole raised to m. So that can be write it as a raised to m into b raised to m. Here also a into b whole raised to m, we have a raised to m into b raised to m. That is 2 raised to minus 5 into 5 raised to minus 5 into 5 raised to 3 and divided by 5 raised to minus 7 into 2 raised to minus 5 into 3 raised to minus 5. At this stage, what we have to do is we have to split this complete equation. So here 3 we have, here 3 we have, here 2 we have, here 2 we have, and here 5 we have. So we have to split in one, in the same numerator and the denominator. Here I have 3 raised to minus 5. So let us take this line here, division line, and 3 raised to 5. On the below of that one, we have to write another 3. Yes, 3 raised to minus 5. Yes. So let us move on to the next. 2. Let's take 2 base. 2 raised to minus 5 u and 2 raised to minus 5. Yes, then. Let's take all the 5's. Here, firstly 5 raised to minus 5 we have and 5 raised to minus 3 we have. Sorry, plus 2. And here, in the denominator we have 5 raised to minus 7. So here just observe here. So here 3 is in the one side and 2 is in one side and 5 is in the one side. So we can easily analyze how can we solve that one. Yes. So here just observe 3 raised to minus 5 divided by 3 raised to minus 5. That is 3 raised to minus 5. So it is a raised to b by a raised to m by a raised to m. So that's why minus of minus 5. And so then let's take 2. Here 2 raised to minus 5, 2 raised to minus 5. That is minus 5 minus of minus 5. How it is formed? So here it is a raised to m minus 1. That is a raised to b by a raised to m by a raised to n is equal to a raised to m minus 1. Here also a raised to m by a raised to n is equal to a raised to m minus n. So also here also I am using the same thing. So 5 raised to minus 5, 5 raised to minus 7. That is 5 raised to minus 5 into here. So 5 raised to minus 7 is there here. So that's why minus of minus 7. So here I am keeping the same, that is 5 raised to 3. Yes, here just observe 3 raised to minus 5 plus 5. 3 raised to minus 5 plus 5 into 2 raised to minus 5 plus 5. Minus of minus plus, here minus of minus plus into. Yes, so here just observe it is a raised to m into a raised to n. So here m is here minus 5 minus into minus 7. Here 3 we have. So we can add that one. So a raised to m into a raised to m plus n. So likewise we can add. That is 5 raised to minus 5 plus 7 plus 3. Yes. So this is the form. Yes. So here we use, that is a raised to m by a raised to n is equal to a raised to m minus n. So in this equation. So here from this we use this equation to get this equation. Yes, then. Here we use only a raised to m into a raised to n is equal to a raised to m plus n. So here we have to simplify. That is 3 raised to 0. That is minus 5 plus 5, 3 raised to 0 into. Here 2 raised to 0. Minus 5 plus 5 getting cancels. 2 raised to 0 into. 5 raised to minus 5 plus 7 plus 3. It means here we have minus 5 plus 7 plus 3 means 5 raised to minus 5 plus 7 plus 3 means it is 10. 10 minus 5 is 5. So is equal to 5 raised to 5 is the answer. So we have the answer. So of this complete problem. So I hope you understood these things. So whatever the problem we have, according to the situation, what is the observation we found there, so which one law of exponent is suitable to solve that equation, so we have to use according to the situation. So I hope you understood that there are many problems are there. So I hope you understood all these things and how to solve that problems also. So those who are watching this video for the first time, please subscribe our channel and don't forget to press the bell icon. You can get the notification of our channel very easily. Also hit the like button. Thank you and all. Be safe and stay home. Thank you.